Blackstone Audio presents JFK Conservative by Ira Stoll. This book is read by Paul Boehmer. Prelude: Our Deep Religious Sense, 1946. Wherever freedom has been in danger, Americans with a deep sense of patriotism have ever been willing to stand at Armageddon and strike a blow for liberty and the Lord. John F. Kennedy, 1946. Boston. July 4, 1946, was the first peacetime 4th of July since America had entered World War II 4.5 years before, and the city, on this morning, had an empty summer feel about it. The holiday fell on a Thursday, so many Bostonians had decided to take Friday off too, and had left for long weekends in Maine or on Cape Cod. Arthur Fiedler had conducted the big opening night concert of the Boston Pops on the Esplanade along the Charles River on July 2nd. Some members of the Boston Symphony Orchestra were already in the Berkshires at Tanglewood. The Boston Red Sox were in first place atop the American League, 6.5 games ahead of the Yankees, but even the Red Sox were out of town, away from Fenway Park. Later on July 4th, Ted Williams, back with the team after nearly 4 years as a Marine and Navy aviator, would hit his 21st and 22nd home runs of the season, one in each game of a doubleheader against the Philadelphia A's. Among those remaining in the city for the holiday was the mayor, James Michael Curley. At 10 a.m., downtown, in front of City Hall, he hoisted the American flag, and a parade of about 500 stepped off down School Street. The detachment from the Army, Marines, Navy, Sons of the American Revolution, and Girl Scouts approached the Granary Burying Ground, where Curley's son, Lieutenant George Curley, placed wreaths on the graves of 3 men who, 170 years earlier, had signed the Declaration of Independence: Robert Treat Paine, John Hancock, and Samuel Adams. Then the parade marched down Tremont Street to the Old State House, where at 10:45 a student from the Boston Latin School stood on the balcony in colonial dress and read the Declaration aloud to the crowd gathered below. Finally, they arrived at Faneuil Hall, the red brick building where Samuel Adams and the Boston Town Meeting had gathered long ago to protest the taxes on tea. This day's featured speech was to be delivered by a slim 29-year-old lieutenant in the Navy Reserve, a veteran of the war in the Pacific, named John Fitzgerald Kennedy. Kennedy began by talking about how religion had shaped Americans and their history, beginning with the original colonists. "Our deep religious sense is the first element of the American character which I would discuss this morning," he said. "The informing spirit of the American character has always been a deep religious sense. Throughout the years, down to the present, a devotion to fundamental religious principles has characterized American thought and action." He went on to discuss the Declaration of Independence itself. "Our government was founded on the essential religious idea of integrity of the individual. It was this religious sense which inspired the authors of the Declaration of Independence. We hold these truths to be self-evident: that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights." Then he moved to the First Amendment of the Constitution. "Our earliest legislation was inspired by this deep religious sense. Congress shall make no law prohibiting the free exercise of religion." He quoted President Washington: "Of all the dispositions and habits which lead to political prosperity, religion and morality are indispensable supports." He quoted President Lincoln.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.